awful darkness and silence reign over the great Grumbulian plain. Through the long, long wintry nights when the angry breakers roar as they beat on the rocky shore, when storm clouds brood on the towering heights, on the hills of the Chankly Bore. There moves what seems a fiery spark, a lonely spark with silvery rays piercing the coal-black night, a meteor strange and bright. Hither and thither the vision strays, a single lurid light. Slowly it wanders, pauses, creeps, anon it sparkles, flashes and leaps. And ever as onward it gleaming goes, a light on the bong tree stems it throws, and those who watch at that midnight hour, from hall or terrace or lofty tower, cry as the wild light passes along, the dong, the dong. The wandering dong through the forest goes, the dong, the dong. The dong with a luminous nose. Long years ago, the dong was happy and gay, till he fell in love with a jumbly-giddle who came to those shores one day. For the jumblies came in a sieve, they did, landing at eve near the Zemri Fid, where the oblong oysters grow, and the rocks are smooth and grey, and all the woods and the valleys rang with the chorus they daily and nightly sang. Far and few, far and few are the lands where the jumblies live. Their heads are green and their hands are blue, and they went to sea in a sieve. Happily, happily passed those days while the cheerful jumbly stayed. They danced in circlets all night long to the plaintive pipe of the lively dong, in moonlight, shine or shade. For day and night he was always there by the side of his jumbly girl, so fair, with her sky blue hands and her sea green hair. Till the morning came of that hateful day when the jumblies sailed in their sieve away, and the dong was left on the cruel shore, gazing, gazing forevermore, ever keeping his weary eyes on that pea-green sail on the far horizon, singing the jumbly chorus still as he sat all day on the grassy hill. Far and few, far and few are the lands where the jumblies live. Their heads are green and their hands are blue, and they went to sea in a sieve. When the sun was low in the west, the dong arose and said, "What little sense I once possessed has gone quite out of my head." And since that day he wanders still by lake and forest, marsh and hill, singing, "Oh, somewhere in valley or plain, might I find my jumbly girl again? Forever I'll seek by lake and shore." Till I find my jumbly girl once more. Playing a pipe with silvery squeak, since then his jumbly girl he seeks, and because by night he could not see, he gathered the bark of the twangum tree in the flowery plain that grows, and he wove him a wondrous nose. A nose as strange as nose could be, of vast proportions and painted red, and tied with cords to the back of his head. In a hollow, rounded space attended, with a luminous lamp within suspended. All fenced about with a bandage stout to prevent the wind from blowing it out. And with poles all round to send the light in gleaming rays on the dismal night. Now each night and all night long over those plains still roams the dong, and above the wail of the chimp and snipe you may hear the squeak of his plaintive pipe, while ever he seeks, but seeks in vain, to meet with his jumbly girl again. Lonely and wild all night he goes, the dong with a luminous nose. And all who watch at the midnight hour, from hall or terrace or lofty tower, cry as they trace the meteor bright, moving along through the dreary night, "This is the hour when forth he goes, the dong with the luminous nose." Yonder, over the plain, he goes. He goes. He goes. The dong with the luminous nose. He goes, he goes, the dong with the luminous nose. He goes, he goes, the dong with the luminous nose.